يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ.
السلام عليكم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, the Almighty asks us to remember to be virtuous to one another. Remember to be kind to everyone so that if a day comes when you are in crisis, at least you would have had a good relationship with everyone. Amongst us there are doctors, amongst us there is the baker, amongst us there is the plumber, amongst us there are the teachers, amongst us there are the scholars. Amongst us there are so many. Remember, there are even the cleaners and those who do all sorts of jobs. Everyone has a diverse life. Allah says, be kind to the people, be kind to everyone, and this will build community, society, and the nation. In this way, whenever there is a crisis, we stand together, shoulder to shoulder. That will be a means of comfort, knowing that everyone is with you. When we have this major crisis, we always hear people saying, we're in it together. Islam teaches us to be in it together even before the crisis. This is what Allah says. وَلَا تَنْسَوُا الْفَضْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah says, do not forget to be virtuous amongst yourselves to one another. And subhanAllah, Allah says, I'm watching. I know what you're doing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the best advice. Sometimes it's difficult. We are so selfish. We think about ourselves and so on. Remember, a kind word. You'll never lose anything by being polite. Greet people. Respond to the greeting. Smile at one another. The small assistance that you may be able to render to those, helping someone pick up a wallet that might have fallen or dropped, helping a person who perhaps has a puncture, the motor vehicle needs a little bit of repair and you've assisted. Remember, it's not all about yourself. It's about us. We are humanity. We are the creatures of the Almighty. Even the animals and the plants, we're all creatures of Allah. So Allah says, take care of each other. You must take care of each other. You see, when I fall ill, I have people looking after me. Imagine if I had a bad relationship with everyone. Who's going to take care of me? My temper. I would have to pay because of my temper. I would have to pay because of my bad habits and qualities. So Allah says, speak respectfully to everyone. You never know when you're going to need them. And if that is the case, you always need Allah. So speak to Allah every day. The verse immediately after that, Allah says, حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Subhanallah. Allah says, protect, safeguard your prayers. Protect them. Make sure you pray, especially the middle prayer. So the middle prayer, that which is most difficult, Salatul Asr, and the prayer that is very difficult, Allah says, protect it. Make sure that you fulfill it. Didn't we say, develop a relationship with Allah, communicate with people in a good way. Allah, you should be communicating with in an even better way. So protect it. The same way we are taught to have good relations with everyone, we are taught to be having the best relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says that in this way, you would definitely be able to save yourself from lots of calamity, lots of hardship. Then, in the same surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about how you need to believe in His power and His might. You call out to Allah and there must be an element of conviction. Go and take a look at the stories of those of the past. He mentions the story of David and Goliath, Dawood and Jalut. David, may peace be upon him on one hand, and Dawood, against all odds. Dawood overcame Goliath or Jalut against all odds. So he was smaller, he had less resources, his weapon was not as grand. And here is Goliath the mighty, who was bragging and boasting about all his might. And with one shot, Dawood or David overcame Jalut. And Allah says, Goliath was no more. So Allah is showing us that, you know what? So many times, a small number has overcome a large number. A small power has overcome a great power. So don't become too proud about your power, your might, your wealth, your looks, your business, whatever else it may be. Don't be proud. You are not far from Allah's might. Allah is mightier than you are. If Allah wants, He can take it away in a flash. He has done it to others. Why do you watch them, hear about them, and think it's never going to happen to you? Well, if you are humble, perhaps it may not happen to you. But if you're haughty, perhaps you may be deserving of that type of Allah's treatment of you, to put it in a respectful way. So my brothers and sisters, Allah gives us this example to say, when you have, don't be proud. When you're in power, serve the people. When you have that authority, serve the people. When people are working for you, treat them well. A day will come when you will work for others, or your children will work for the children of those who used to work for you. The tables turn. Allah says the tables don't remain the same. So in order to cater for a rainy day, you must be very wise. You must have some foresight. That's what Allah is saying. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He owns entire universe. There is a verse in Surah Al-Baqarah called Ayatul Kursi, the verse wherein the pedestal is mentioned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you read that verse thrice in the morning, thrice in the evening, you will be protected from the devil. You will be protected from the whispers of the devil and from him coming to you and harming you. You want comfort? Read Ayatul Kursi. Read it thrice in the morning, thrice in the evening, that verse. Read it once after every prayer. This is what we're taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This verse has in it the greatness of Allah, the fact that He doesn't sleep, He doesn't get tired, the fact that He protects everything. Nothing can escape Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we were to repeat these verses, we would definitely be able to achieve comfort at night. You want to sleep well? Well, you need to lay your trust in Allah. Lock your doors, read your Ayatul Kursi, read the little prayers that they are for the evening, and go to bed. Lay your trust in Allah. You will sleep, as we say, like a log. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters, when you lay your trust in Allah, when you've tied your camel, you locked everything, you did whatever you could, and you prayed to Allah, what more do you want? Don't worry, relax, be at ease. Allah will give you the comfort. Allah will grant you the most beautiful sleep ever, because you related your sleep to Allah. You prayed and sought forgiveness before you slept. When you got up, you pray and you seek forgiveness and thank Allah for a new day. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, used to say, if you take my soul during my sleep, then forgive it, give it paradise. And if you are to release it again and get me up from my sleep, then protect it in the way that you protect your pious servants. What a beautiful prayer. What a beautiful prayer. Many of us don't know it, and sometimes we couldn't be bothered. We're too tired. We forget to say the name of the Almighty the last thing at night, the first thing in the morning. What type of comfort would you like? My brothers and sisters, if you really want comfort, if you're really searching for comfort, you need to develop that relation with Allah. Call out to Him. Say His name in the evening. Say His name in the morning. Praise Him morning and evening. Pray to Him. Repeat the verses of revelation. They are powerful. That is the word of Allah. To say the word of the Almighty as it was revealed is by far the most powerful way of declaring the greatness of Allah and even protecting yourself from matters of the unseen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. And this is why He says, Allahu waliyyul ladhina amanu. Immediately after that, He says, Allah is the protector of those who believe. That belief, that conviction, that faith in the one and only He who made you, that conviction will see you through. No doubt. No doubt at all. He says, He is the protector of those who believe. My brothers and sisters, we must be grateful to Allah. He has removed us from the darkness and He has definitely brought us to the light. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how He will multiply the reward of those who spend in His cause on condition that they don't brag about what they have spent. So sometimes there is a crisis and mashallah, we've got money, so we spend and we make a big deal of it and we actually brag about it and we tell the whole world about it in a way that is not encouraging them to give. Because if you were to tell others in a way that you want to encourage them, that's a good deed. But if you are to brag about it and look what I did and I did this and I did that, Allah says, we don't count that good deed. It's actually against you, not for you. You want comfort. When you spend, hide it. Don't show others. Don't brag about it. Don't spoil your good deeds by bragging about the good deed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who spend in our cause, we multiply it for them 700-fold and beyond. And Allah says, those who spend and do not follow up that spending with bragging and with harm, then we will give them a good reward and for them is paradise. But for those who spend and then they harm and then they brag about it and they expect as a result of their charity to be treated in a special way simply because they were charitable, Allah says, well, we gave you your treatment in the world. Now what do you want? You know, so this is why Allah says, don't brag, be humble. The best of those who give are those who give in such a way that nobody will know that they've given, or that people know that they have given, but they are so humble that people won't believe that this is the person who gave. This is how we should be as believers, my brothers and sisters, no matter what the Almighty has given you. Be humble. Don't brag about things. Don't harm people. We've been saying this every other day. This is in the Quran. These are the verses that Allah has revealed to us. He has disciplined us both in worship as well as in our treatment of others. May Allah bless you all. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salati innallaha ma'as-sabirin.